Hello, welcome, Ed Show.
Hey, welcome to the show. Today I'm going to be talking to two guys who have created this fantastic book on Enterprise Mobility Suite, obviously something very, very dear to my heart. And it's probably the first book that's out there on EMS. What's really unique about it is that it's actually a scenario-based book. It's situational. So it takes you through something from a place where you probably are if you are just looking at Enterprise Mobility Suite, and it actually brings you into being able to use the product, deploy it, and also, very importantly, be able to fix it when you get those little niggles that we all get as ID pros. So very, very useful to have that kind of thing all together. Brad wrote the foreword for this book and is very, very kind of glowing in that kind of praise, and he probably knows what he's talking about with that particular product. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce the two authors of the book. We've got Yuri Diogenes, and we've also got Jeff Gilbert. Both of you guys actually work inside of Microsoft as well in the CSI team, which is probably something that most people don't know anything about outside of Microsoft. Has a very cool name. Nothing to do with trying to understand who solved what particular crimes.
Yeah.
What does CSI actually do?
So CSI is the Cloud Services International, or Content Services International. We do all the content for Cloud Enterprise Division. So everything Azure, all the way through Enterprise Mobility.
Right, in our case in particular, we are at the Enterprise Mobility team, because CSI is the organization, right? So there are divisions, we are on the Enterprise Mobility team, doing mobile device management, Enterprise Mobility Suite, and all that stuff.
So when these folks go and actually get hold of the technical documentation on how all of this stuff works, so you guys that are writing it, so that's pretty valuable to people out there, frankly, and it's pretty incredible. And it also means that that you're using the products in order to be able to build out all of that documentation and working with engineering to get a really deep understanding. So that kind of stuff must have made it a little bit easier to work on this book.
And challenging, mainly for the book, right? Yeah. Because as we were wrote, it changed, right?
Yeah.
So it was pretty challenging also to do that.
So how did you approach the book? Why the scenario-based approach?
Well, we were thinking, if I'm a consultant and I'm trying to implement enterprise mobility, what do I need to know first? And we were like, well, first of all, you need to understand the whys of many things. Why you're going to implement this? Why is important to consider security since the beginning of the project, right? Because people tend to believe that enterprise mobility is pretty much BYOD, and it is not. So what are the scenarios for BYOD? What are the scenarios for company-owned devices? The difference of those things. So we said, okay, let's start from setting this foundation so that from that point on that I create this foundation, I can move to the pillars of enterprise mobility. So the pillars pretty much were the identity, the device management, and data protection. So we distributed the book in such a way that we explain the capability, and the chapter right after that we implemented. Now the cool thing that we did at the beginning was we created this fictitious company with a fantastic logo that Jeff put together that has...
So you're also a graphic designer in your
part, right? Yeah. That has a lot of requirements, right? And we were very cautious to say, okay, they have on-premise infrastructure they need to integrate. So how can we do that in a real-world scenario? And we actually deploy everything in
it's still live right now,
yeah.
So it is the kind of scenario that most folks are going to go through if they're going to try and do this themselves. It's going to be the kind of thing which hopefully is going to be very, very relevant to people when they start to actually think, huh, my company has that thing as well. We need to actually put that particular part of this in place. In terms of the depth that you go into, it sounds like it could be a pretty light, fluffy book. But I'm guessing that since you guys have done it, it probably isn't.
You know, it's amazing how much detail you can get into in a book that's only, 300 pages long?
Yeah.
We really go really in-depth on a lot of things, a lot of it about customizing it for your organization, a lot of the big things that people use the products for. We really get into a lot of detail. I think we probably cover probably 80% case of what everybody's going to do with EMS, at least to begin with.
If you implement everything that we explain, you're going to have a pretty solid scenario to embrace mobility and have all the capabilities. And the last two chapters of the book, we went through two very important considerations for operations and management, because once you have everything up and running, now what should I do, right? You probably already have some sort of incident response in place. How can I leverage enterprise mobility to help me identify secure breaches, to help me to respond to something? So that's also that we wanted to explore this side, because people, many times, they just put things together and think that it's self-maintained without really doing the operations as it should. And the last chapter is a troubleshooting chapter, because we faced that when we were implementing. So we're like, why not document?
Yeah, and I was just going through this troubleshooting chapter a couple of moments ago, just flipping through it. And I can just tell just from the pictures that you're using of parts of the interface, I'm like, I've never seen that before.
That all really happened.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting, because it means that you are going that extra level of depth, and it's a pretty fantastic thing to have a book that is both scenario based and technically deep enough to really get the points over.
Yeah, it's really and really we began at the beginning with hybrid identity, mm-hmm. right? So I know there's a lot of people, a lot of organizations that are kind of scared of ADFS.
Yeah.
But we really walk you through the easiest way to do it possible. So everything from a lot of organizations are used to kind of on-prem AD. They're not very familiar with Azure AD yet.
Yeah.
So we start off that section of the book by describing what Azure AD Premium is, the reports, capabilities, those kinds of things. We talk through all the different synchronization tools that you can use to synchronize your on-prem with Azure. We recommend one, obviously, uh-huh. right?
Yeah, the very specific one,
I
guess.
We take you through it for Azure AD Connect,
yeah.
Which is in preview right now still. But that's going to give you two options, right? So you can do same sign-on with password hash sync. Or we also talk you through all the way through ADFS with single sign-on for identity, mm-hmm. right? And then so once the users are synchronized with Azure AD, we can leverage them with Microsoft Intune. So from there, we talk you through all the features and capabilities that Intune gives you to manage your devices, manage your users, and allow your employees to bring the devices they want to work, right, in a secure and safe way. So we also go through a lot of the features, the in-depth features of Intune around conditional access to email, right, so we're securing access to corporate data and email through our security policies, right? And then we move on to really securing the data.
Yeah, in the data protection chapter, we start also trying to leverage things that are on-premise, because the entire solution can be way more stronger if you start leveraging things that are built in on Windows Server already,
yeah.
Like Dynamic Access Control. Why not integrate that? How can I integrate Azure RMS with my file server and my work folder? So there are the whole story can be way more secure when you start leveraging those capabilities that are in place already. And sometimes people just don't realize they are already there. And the good thing about enterprise mobility with Azure RMS is that you can integrate those things, right? So the data will be secure on-premise, off-premise, no matter where you go. So we go through this whole rationale in chapter 7, and in chapter 8, we implement that. Yeah. So always this approach. We give the theory, how it works, because it's important to people understand the whys, and then we go to the hands-on.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. I think that you've essentially built the cookbook for enterprise mobility, which I think is rather nice. How was it to actually write the book? What was the experience like? Did you end up spending many, many late nights working on it?
It was a Christmas present.
Yeah. Yuri's a harsh taskmaster.
Oh, right? Okay. Nice.
Get me working over the holidays. No.
Ooh.
Yeah, it was actually a lot of fun.
It was fun.
Learned a lot. Because really in my day-to-day role, I'm really more focused on Configuration Manager, Microsoft Intune.
Yeah.
So for me, it gave me a chance to kind of reach out into Azure AD, learn more about identity, learn more about the tools. And really, honestly, I discovered how easy it was to do ADFS. That was my big, wow, that was my Christmas
present. And we had a really tight schedule with Microsoft Press, because they really wanted to have this at Ignite.
Yeah.
And the whole process of doing it, reviewing it, takes time. So we had a pretty tight schedule, and so we work over the holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, yeah. New Year's Eve.
Wow, there's a lot of kind of blood, sweat, and tears gone into it, then, I guess, in that case. So it's pretty cool. You've also produced something which most IT folks out there are going to love. Every time I go to anybody's office and I walk around and I see everybody's cubicles, I start to see these things actually appearing on the walls. You've produced an enterprise mobility poster.
Oh, yeah.
And this is actually the first time I've ever seen the entire architecture for enterprise mobility expressed on a single sheet of paper. It's actually awesome. Talk us through what you've actually created here.
Well, this is was really a teamwork, because we had PMs from all products working together on this. And we had also, besides myself, we have Robert Marzoli from our team doing a lot of hard work on this. Thomas, Keith, all PMs from different features that were giving their feedback, because that's what we want. We want an IT pro type of poster. We didn't want marketing oriented. We want to show the architecture, how those pieces work together, mm-hmm. right? How can we express that and keep the technicality? That's really what we want to do. And I think it captured, because we presented this poster here at Ignite, and it's been a success. People really enjoy looking at those capabilities. And if you look at the poster, for example, you'll see that we have on-premise and cloud, because very important also to emphasize how the solution integrates with on-premise.
Yeah, that is actually one of the things that I really love about it. It's really clear which is which. The blue section at the top is the cloud, the gray section down the bottom being the on-prem. So just going through this, we start off with the nice user scenario of actually signing in. But then it starts to show you what's actually happening there. So you land inside of the identity space very quickly. So what's going on inside of identity?
So inside the identity, we're showing you kind of, here's the on-prem Active Directory that everyone's used to, right? And then we're showing how we synchronize it with Azure AD. Get up there. We also show all the available SaaS applications that are out there that everybody's accessing through this hybrid identity model.
Yeah.
Also Azure Active Directory, what's it called?
SaaS apps?
Yep. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah, tied through the multi-factor authentication also, it's available through there.
Yeah.
Right? And once you've got your identity figured out and sorted, you move on to kind of the devices, right? So what devices are those users using? And those are being managed, obviously, by Microsoft Intune through coordination both with the on-prem Configuration Manager, on-prem Exchange,
yep.
Up into the cloud with Microsoft Intune and Exchange Online as well. And with that management, you have control the policies to secure data and email access.
Yep.
All right, and also provide access to those applications, right?
Yeah, and you've even got conditional access built into there with essentially segregating the SharePoint and the Exchange servers on-prem if you want to, and also giving you the conditional access out to Office 365 as well through Microsoft Intune, so pretty cool.
Very interesting to go through this flow in this particular order, because identity is the first thing that you're going to hit when you authenticate, right? So we had many discussions of the order of each pillar. And if you look at the data, is further down, because the data, after you manage all the apps, who is going to consume the data? It might be the app, right? You might not have direct access to the data. You might have access to the data through the app. So the app is going to consume the data. So we need to protect the data, no matter if the user is accessing from a file server or through the app, right? So we have, in the poster, it clarifies that Azure RMS can be used to protect data if it is consuming the app or in the file server, for example.
Very cool.
Or integrated with SharePoint Exchange as well.
Yeah, it's amazing the way it actually all comes together. It's just a really nice model. So if you want to get hold of the book, you've created an AKA MS link with that, which is AKA slash MS EM poster. Yep, so you guys can go and download that. I'll make sure we have that inside of the notes for this particular show. And you can get hold of the book through any any online bookstore, retailer, direct from Microsoft Press. And you can also get hold of this as an e-publication as well, and as a EPUB, and the physical copy if you want to buy them as a bundle. Gentlemen, thank you very much for coming along and joining and
for having us.
Explaining the book, the process, and everything else. And we'll see you next time.
Hello, welcome. Ed Sh-